Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to do something really simple to our 2003 Yamaha T60 outboard. We're just going to change out the spark plugs. But there's a couple of tips I want to pass on to you that may keep you from getting into trouble later on. So if you're ready, let me get that cowling out of the way and I'll show you how to do it. Let's start by removing the plugs. And I usually just do them one at a time. These seem to be in decent shape, and this is when you want to take a peek to see how your burn is. We're maybe a tick on the rich side, but I would rather have that versus too lean, because too lean means you're running too hot and you can overheat your engine. But these looks like they've done their tour of duty, so we want to go ahead and get those replaced. Now here's the first of two things I want to talk about. If you put these back in and don't torque them correctly, you run the risk of actually shearing these off. Now this particular plug, it has a pretty thick wall on the threads. Now there are some on different units where that gets very thin, and if you over torque it, you can snap it. And on this one, it would be easy to get to, but others, they're so far down in the head, you would actually have to pull the head to extract the threads that broke off. So you really need to be careful when you go to tighten these. The other thing I want to point out is, especially for marine applications in a saltwater environment, I would recommend using anti-seize, but you need to make sure that it is made for marine application, which this one is, because some anti-seize, they have different composite metals in there that can actually cause galvanic corrosion, and that's what you're trying to avoid, especially in a saltwater environment. So I recommend using the anti-seize, just make sure that it's a marine grade compound. Otherwise, it can get you into trouble. It doesn't take a lot. You just want to put a little bit around on the threads. You don't even have to go all the way around, because as you turn it in, it's going to distribute it. All right, guys, if you do not have an accurate torque wrench, the rule of thumb on a new spark plug is to take it in finger tight and then add 3/4 of a turn, so 270 degrees. So you would go from here to 9 o'clock, and that should be close or get you in the ballpark to the recommended 13 foot-pounds from the manufacturer. So let's see how accurate that 270 degrees is. So by the time this wrench is pointing this direction, we should be at that 13 foot-pounds. But remember, this is on a new spark plug. That's pretty close. Look at that. That's 13, so a little bit more, it would have been okay. But I want to stress, that is for a new spark plug. If you try this on a used spark plug that's already been compressed, that 270 or 3/4 of a turn is going to be way too much. If we took out one of the old ones, loosened it up, took it back finger tight, let's see how much it would take to get to that 13 foot-pounds with an already compressed gasket or ring. Not far at all. See the big difference there? So if you really want to be sure about this, go and invest in a good torque wrench. That's the procedure. I just need to replicate that 3 more times. Whew, that one's looking rough. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up this little project. All I need to do now is reinstall the cowl and then maybe find a boat to mount this motor to. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at Boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.